more pain lies ahead for the Chinese stock market. And according to our next guest, a lot. It is our call of the day today. Tom DeMark is the market studies founder and CEO. He is live today from Phoenix. Mr. DeMark, welcome back.
Great to be back.
I'm sure you just heard the report, in your ear, these folks over there in China were actually calling CNBC asking for help in getting their money back. How much more pain are they going to have to endure there?
Well, it's speculative right now. We're pretty confident that we should at least move down to 3,200. The die has already been cast in that regard. And it's just we have to reassess the market once it reaches 3,200. If I could just give you a little background, in 1987, when the stock market had that big move into its August 25th peak, the 2722 level on the Dow Jones average, if you were to take something as simple as a normal Fibonacci retracement of the raw figure 2722, you'd arrive at the low that was recorded October 20th. So that's one instance of when the market declined approximately 62%, but was able to recover off that low. The same thing happened at the 2000 peak of March of the March 24th of the S&P peak. If you were to take 61.8% or 62% of that peak up there, you at 1527.46, you would arrive exactly at 944.75, right to the tick.
I mean,
which was the low on September 21st.
I apologize for interrupting. I mean, it's a lot of numbers for people to try and keep track
sure.
of as you're ticking them off. You're essentially looking for the Chinese stock market to decline by another, I believe, 14%. Some of your predictions come true, some don't. It's the way the game is played. You say the die has been cast. What exactly do you mean by that?
What I was trying to convey was that at those two prior periods, both in 1987 and 2000, the die was cast quickly off those peaks, and the market did correct to 62% of the decline. And what we're seeing right now is with the peak in the Shanghai on June 12th, at peak above 5,100, a 62% retracement there is 3,200. We have a number of other indicators which also confirm anywhere from 3,198 to 3,200. What we've got to do is reassess the market once it reaches that level. We got into a quagmire back in February of 2014, if you recall. There was a lot of controversy and a lot of publicity and sensationalism that we were predicting 1929 collapse. We were not. We were on the air with your people saying certain preconditions had to occur before we would be confident to the point that we were going to mimic 1929. We're going to go through the same process, I think, once the Shanghai reaches 3,200, because if the preconditions which we think could precipitate further weakness appear, then we will turn all out bearish, and we think we could reproduce what happened in 1929.
So of course
things are changing from day to day. Like today, for example, we got a buy signal, a very short-term buy signal on the Shanghai composite. We think the market's going to go up. When we got the tailwind of the U.S. markets, we think there's a good rally coming in the U.S. markets, possibly to new highs on some indices. So that's going to carry the Shanghai. But the Shanghai will probably only decline, advance 3 to 4 days, and then it should lead on the downside.